This video is brought to you by IXL, used by millions of students worldwide to get ahead in math, English, and more.
Hello, students. Today we'll be using the distance formula. Let's dive in. Say we want to find the distance between 5, negative 1, and 8, 3. Let's look at a graph to help us. We want to find the distance, but we can't simply count this. So what do we do? Well, we can draw a right triangle to help us. This is the horizontal distance between our points, which we can find by subtracting the x-coordinates. 8 minus 5 is 3. And this is the vertical distance between our points, so we'll subtract the y-coordinates to find it. 3 minus negative 1 is 4. Now we can use the Pythagorean theorem to find the distance between our points. Plugging in our values of 3 and 4, and simplifying, we get that the distance is 5 units. Great work! But there wasn't anything special about these points. Let's see if we can generalize this. Let's say we have two points, x1, y1, and x2, y2. We'll use the same method as before. So we'll draw a right triangle to help find the distance d. To find the horizontal distance, we can subtract the x-coordinates. And to find the vertical distance, we subtract the y-coordinates. Now, we can plug this into the Pythagorean theorem. The distance squared will equal the horizontal distance squared plus the vertical distance squared. To simplify, we need to square root both sides. This gives us distance equals the square root of x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. So this is the general distance formula. It will allow us to find the distance between any two points on the coordinate plane. Nice. Let's try it out with some more examples. Find the distance between the points negative 2, negative 3, and 10, negative 8. I have the formula ready to go. The first ordered pair will be our x1, y1 values, and the second ordered pair will be our x2, y2 values. Let's color coordinate. Let's make the x values green and the y values purple. Okay, let's start substituting. x2 minus x1 becomes 10 minus negative 2, and y2 minus y1 becomes negative 8 minus negative 3. 10 minus negative 2 becomes 12, and 8 minus negative 3 becomes negative 5. Let's simplify those squares. 12 squared is 144, and negative 5 squared is 25. Let's add those two values. 144 plus 25 is 169. And finally, the square root of 169 is 13. Got it. The distance between these points is 13 units. Nice job. Let's try another one. Find the distance between the points negative 3, 7 and negative 15, negative 9. We'll use the distance formula and substitute in our values. x2 minus x1 becomes negative 15 minus negative 3, and y2 minus y1 becomes negative 9 minus 7. Negative 15 minus negative 3 becomes negative 12, and negative 9 minus 7 becomes negative 16. Negative 12 squared is 144, and negative 16 squared is 256. 144 plus 256 is 400, and the square root of 400 is 20. We got it again. The distance between these points is 20 units. Awesome! Great job on these problems. Take your time with the distance formula and you'll get better and better at using it. You got this.
Head over to IXL.com to check out this video and thousands more in math and language arts.